తార్నాకలో జరుగుతున్న యంగ్ సైంటిస్టులకు అవార్డుల ప్రదానోత్సవ కార్యక్రమంలో మంత్రి కేటీఆర్ మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. ఇప్పుడు లైవ్ చూద్దాం.
ఈస్ అర్బనైజేషన్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ కాన్సిక్వెన్సెస్ యాజ్ వీ ఆల్ నో హైదరాబాద్ యాజ్ అ సిటీ ఇస్ కన్సిస్టెంట్లీ రేటెడ్ యాజ్ అ సిటీ విత్ ద బెస్ట్ క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ లివింగ్ ఫర్ ద లాస్ట్ 3 years. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ ఐ మస్ట్ షేర్ దిస్ విత్ యూ. An agency called Mercer, which rates cities on a livability index across the world, has been rating Hyderabad as a city with the best quality of living in India. But as we all admit, as we all know, as people who travel the world, as people who see other cities and the way they have been shaping up, while things have been slowly but steadily improving in the city of Hyderabad, the law and order situation has improved significantly in the last 4 years. The water supply has been increasing, has increased substantially in the last 4 years. The power situation, which was very erratic prior to the formation of Telangana, has improved substantially in the last 4 years. But there are still areas where we have to get our act together. One of the significant challenges with respect to Hyderabad is the rapid urbanization that's happening here. Not just Hyderabad, but in fact, every single urban agglomeration faces this problem. My request to Telangana Academy of Sciences also on this front is, a lot of times urbanization leads to negative consequences, especially with respect to environment and infrastructure. Now I would request you to also possibly form a subcommittee on this and guide us, especially the impact on environment, because I'm sure there are scientists and there are fellows who are from the environmental sciences background. We would request you to work with us, because we have our own plans. Of course, we parallelly are working on it. About 192 forest blocks within 100-kilometer radius around Hyderabad are being developed as urban lung spaces. We are working on that, and we continue to work on that. We are working on Musi beautification and Musi cleaning and liquid waste management in the city of Hyderabad. And we are consistently making efforts to ramp up our urban infrastructure. But I think these three areas, like I said, irrigation, possibly a subcommittee, and guiding us with what kind of crop colonies can come up, because monocropping will destroy soil fertility, as we all know. And monocropping, of course, is detrimental, even in terms of the farmers getting a fair price in the market. So therefore, a possible subcommittee on that, and a second possible subcommittee on how to sensitize people on the good consequences, the positive consequences of industrialization, employment, and how can we even tackle the pollution hazards that have happened in the past. Because a lot of things are fresh in the minds of people. You know, the Bhopal tragedy, the unfortunate tragedies even inside or close to the city of Hyderabad, and also consequences of urbanization. If Professor Narasimha Reddy can guide the government on these three fronts, I'll be grateful. Now, like many of you, I also very strongly believe science and innovation are the primary drivers of long-run economic growth, because most of the industry, most of the enterprises that have come about in the world today have come out from some premier scientific labs, have come out from some brilliant minds. Now, the only way for sustained employment provision is by way of encouraging the private sector, by way of encouraging innovation, by way of encouraging more and more enterprise and free market economy. Now, that's something government of Telangana has been doing, championing, in fact, consistently. That's why we are ranked number one on the ease of doing business index, which is a joint ranking, which is a ranking given by both DIPP and also the World Bank jointly together. We are delighted that we've been consistently maintaining that position. But at the same time, I think what's equally important to realize, in fact, when we were sitting up in the director's room and chatting, he said something very nonchalantly, which I latched onto and which I teased him about also. He said, we've published a lot of papers in many, many journals, which people hardly bother to read. My request to all the scientists in this room is, I possibly could have ended up and, joined one of you if I had gone on after my post-graduation to pursue a PhD. But my question to all of you, and at least some of you, is most of the science, most of the research that happens in our country, unfortunately, remains either in beautiful and wonderful publications, the science journals across the world and across India as well, or is confined to the wonderful institutions that we so proudly cherish. See, CCMB, for example, or IICT, or some of the other wonderful names, in fact, in our own state, NGRI, like I said, NIN, CFTRI, ICRISAT, IDPL, etc., etc., all of these are truly eminent institutions which have really, really provided this country and the world great deal of inputs and great deal of amazing interventions with respect to science. But how much of it is actually known by the common man? How much of this research that happens in these eminent scientific institutions has had a commercial application? In a country like India, the reason why I say this is because in a country like India, unfortunately, science and scientific research still has a very elitist image. You might not like what I said. You may not be happy with what I'm saying. The fact is, the scientific research in this country, in our country, still has...